It's very exciting, the level of player, the standard, the quality, experience, everything that's been brought in has been great. Obviously, the training so far, we've only seen a couple of the new lads involved for one reason or another. So, but no, great. That's really exciting times, and I think it just gets everybody really looking forward to the start of the new season.
Do you think this shows the club's intent for the new season?
Listen, it was always going to be that way. I mean, the manager spoke about it towards the end of last season, what the expectations would be for this season, and I think it has been a real signal of intent that he's backed that up with a level and the standard of signings that we've made so far.
That means you're not the oldest player anymore.
It does. That was one of the big bonuses they signed Clint.
Kenny, do you feel that players are now looking over their shoulder? Last season it was well documented that sometimes Rangers couldn't fill a bench. Is that a good thing, that competition for places that there seems to
be? I think it's huge. A football club like ours, it should be that way. There should be nobody who should be guaranteed or taking that starting slot on a Saturday for granted. You shouldn't need to earn it, and you should be pushed at every game for the season for your jersey, and like I said, you learn that right to be your performances and the consistency through the season to earn that place in that starting 11. Last season, like you says, we toiled to fill a bench in the semi-final in the cup games. This season it'll not be like that. It'll be a real strength and depth and real competition all over the field.
Do you feel that already in training, in terms of the way the boys are training? Have they lifted themselves and lifted the...
Well, listen, it's pre-season training. It's the first 4 or 5 days we've had, and it's been tough. But compare it to last season where we were at, we're in a far better position.
You look at Nico Kranjčar today, Sunday, I think I recall a Scotland game where you scored and he scored with Scotland-Croatia. What does he bring to the team in terms of the quality and experience?
Listen, it goes along with Joy, Clint. They three signings in particular, with the experience they've got, the level at which they've played the game all their careers, it speaks for itself, and that's only going to be a positive thing for us as players. That level of player is coming to our club, it can only help us and make us better and stronger. With the younger lads that are coming, who are going to be hungry and eager to prove, and maybe at the other end of the spectrum, John Rossiter, Josh Windass, big crooks, he obviously is injured at the moment, but they've come in, and there's a great blend. I think the manager's done a fantastic job over at the moment. I mean, he's still talking about bringing maybe another couple in. So the signings we've made at the moment, the manager's done a fantastic job in getting a really good blend of experience and lads who have been over the course and distance, winners, leaders, which is the more guys like that you can get in your team, then the better chance you've got of being successful, in my opinion.
Joey Barton loves to mix it up. What have you made of that so far?
I'm bored of it. Absolutely bored of it so far. But again, it's all tongue-in-cheek. It's all good for our game that there's a spotlight on it again. It's definitely been missed over the last 3 or 4 years. It's been good banter so far, and obviously going into the new season, it does bring attention to our game.
Kenny, you mentioned there about the experienced lads coming in. Did you feel in certain games last year that's what Rangers might have needed to get over the line in key matches?
Well, see, and I think the only key match we probably never got over the line would have been the cup final, where I feel the situation with the breaking things was all. I mean, it was highlighted. I mean, there's no getting away from the fact that it wasn't ideal with that 3 week break before the cup final, and it's no excuses, because on the day that we never turned up, we never turned up on the ball the way we had played in bigger games, Celtic, Dundee, Kilmarnock. The bigger games that we really turned up and imposed ourselves in the game, I don't feel we've done that in that game. Off the ball, we probably weren't really at it again, the same as we had been in the other games. So it was disappointing, in particular the fact there was a real opportunity to win the Scottish Cup, have European football again this year. It was really disappointing, but we'll learn for that. Had we had maybe a little bit more experience, would have helped, who knows. But for us as a team and as a group, on that day, we were really disappointed with ourselves.
Still, obviously, a couple of months to go before the transfer window, and you said there might be another couple of players coming. What you've seen so far, how well equipped do you think the squad is to challenging Celtic?
Well, that's the question. I mean, I think with the squad we had last year, we were in a good place with the right additions in the right positions. Then I always said we would have an opportunity to challenge this year, because there's no other goal. It's not a case of consolidation. It's not a case of top six or European football. It's winning the league is the goal. So I think the signings we've made, the work that we've done so far, is a real signal that is going to be the case. I keep coming back to the quality of these players. It's the levels that these guys have played at all through their career. Even the younger lads at the clubs that they've played for, and John playing at Liverpool, the education he's going to have had at that football club, I think it's only going to stand us in good stead for the season up and coming. Let's say added to an already very good squad, by the way.
Nico said his first question to Matt Robertson when he met him was, is the aim to win the league? Is it important that everybody who sees here and comes here has that same aim, that you know definitely that is the aim to win the league?
You know what, there's one thing to have the aim, and there's another thing to actually, it's an expectation here, and it's a demand. It's not, oh well, we want to do it. We must do it. We have to go and win the league. We have to be successful in cup competitions because this club demands it. The manager and David demand it every single day for us in training. So every player needs to have that mindset. Again, the manager was quoted a lot last year saying that second's nothing here. We need to go and win the league. If we don't, we need to go and at least mount the best challenge that we can and be the best we can every single game that we're going to play. And again, come back to the signings we've made, I think that is a real signal intent that is the aim, that is the expectation, and that's the demands that we put on us as players for the rest of the season.
Kenny, how does it feel for you this time round? You know, obviously had a few spells now, but is there a different feeling now after 4 years out with this club?
I think the difference is that we are a club and a team that is in the process of rebuilding ourselves back to potentially being champions of Scotland. When I came here the first time, say, we're champions, we're championship winning teams. There was no questions like, oh, what's your aims this season? Are you going to win the league? Because that was just a given. Now we're in a stage where we are rebuilding. And again, the manager's done a fantastic job at doing that last season, putting a really good, hungry, young squad together to go and win the championship last year, and the base of a really good squad to go on and build a challenge this year. With the additions that we've made, there's no doubt we're in a good place in terms of numbers and quality that we've got within the numbers that we can go and mount a challenge this year.
And can you do that by playing the exact same way you did?
Well, the manager wouldn't have it any other way. I mean, it's no secret how we've set our stall last year. People said we could maybe do it against Dundee, where I think it was potentially our best performance of the season. The way we played, on and off the ball, the actual final result, 4-0, could have been 5 or 6 or 7, the way we played that day. The Celtic game, you'll not have that level of possession against, well, we did have that level of possession against Celtic. And I felt, particularly in the first half, the way we played was, again, right up there with the Dundee performance. The result was huge, so there's no way we're going to change. There might be tweaks within it, like we've always said, there might be little tweaks positionally within that system and within that style of play, but the way we want to play won't change.
Matt Jilks, you'll know well from Scotland, if he comes on board, is that again another experienced head that's required?
About Big Jillo, all we'll say is the exact same things we'll say as the other guys. I mean, I spoke to him a couple of years ago about our club, and he just fits everything that we're about. He's an experienced player. He's a winner. He's willing to come here and work, fight for his place, and put again. We've talked about competition with places. Now there is some real competition if Matt Jilks comes in, because he's a top international goalie with a lot of experience at a good level down in England. So again, that's only going to be healthy for us as a team moving forward.
And how much do you think, and how much do you hope to be playing this season personally?
Oh well, listen, all you can do is get a good pre-season on your belt. I know it's cliche, but it is really important that every player gets through pre-season unscathed, gets a good level of fitness, gets the right amount of game time in preparation. For me, last season, I felt I had a good season, I got a good amount of goals, finished the season strongly, and my mindset will never change. I want to be playing football every week. I want to be playing every minute, every game. I fully appreciate that that's not going to happen, and it's not about me or any other individual playing every week. It's about the team and the team being successful, but I want to play a huge part in that team being successful.
And your training, is it still kind of, do you still train every day? Or?
Every day, yep. Every day, every session, unless told otherwise, yep.
Kenny, in terms of Scottish football, you mentioned that a bit earlier, but Rangers have sold a lot of season tickets, so Celtic, Hearts, Aberdeen, even in the Championship teams are building now as well. Do you feel the perception will start to change again and the reputation will go up of Scottish football?
Well, I definitely think the the spotlight's been on us a lot more with the appointment of Brendan as Celtic manager, the signings of Joey Barton, Clayton Hull, now Nico Cranshaw coming to our club. It's definitely put the attention back on it. Whether it'll go up, it depends on the quality of the football. I mean, for us, we've sold over 37,000 season tickets, which is a fantastic place to be. And the fans, again, you can't speak highly enough of the level of support we've had through the leagues. And I'm sure that'll be even more so going into that first home game against Hamilton in the league. It'll be I remember the first game last season, St Mirren, the fans were, I was suspended, and the atmosphere was unbelievable. I mean, people talk about Rangers the old and an Ibrox the old, that really had a real feel. Optimism, everybody looking forward to a new season under a new manager with a new team, and the place was electric. I imagine that'll be tenfold come Hamilton on August the 6th.